Thank you for choosing to watch this video. I'm P.C. Nivasan from Provinces Education and Consulting, a global REP of PMI. PMI have recently changed the PMP application form by simplifying some of the sections. Major change is on documenting your experience summary. This video will help you to map your experience according to PMI guidelines and reduce the chance of getting your application rejected. All the best for your successful PMP journey. This is a brief checklist released by PMI regarding how to document your projects. Now, your project should have at least a minimum of 4 weeks and above. Projects like your own personal wedding or any degree level academic research program, creation of newsletters and any minor home improvement projects should be avoided. They may not be acceptable by PMI. Now, if you have been doing multiple projects, you need to individually list them. Do not combine all projects and then list it as one project. Some of them, they put their role in the project title. Please avoid. The project title should clearly describe the project. For example, if your project is to implement a CRM application, title it as CRM implementation project. Now, the next one is a big area. How do you document your experience? Now, earlier it used to be 550 characters. Now, PMI allows you to write anywhere between 200 to 500 words. So, this will help you to document your experience in detail. Now, I will explain you more in detail in the coming slides how you should go forward. Do not document your routine, operational or administrative tasks and responsibilities. Your experience on one-of-a-kind unique projectized initiatives should be brought into this. Now, the other two bullets I'll cover as part of the details that I will discuss in the coming slides. So, this is a major challenge for the project managers. How do they articulate their project experience in line with the PMI guidelines? So, let me take you through step by step. So, this is the replica of the experience documentation section of your PMP application form. So, enter your project experience starting with the most recent. You can go up to 8 years. Total number of experience that should be brought in should be more than 36 months. So you may have to provide start date, finish date, and other areas like what is the methodology followed in the project, what was your team size, project budget, your role and the organization. The second major part of this is to describe the project, your roles and responsibilities. So you need to summarize them. That includes the project objective, outcome, your role in the project. and the deliverables. So a typical response could be anywhere between 200 to 500 words. Now, how should we go about writing this piece? So let me give you an easy method to go forward with it. The PMI gives you an examination content outline document, which we normally call it as ECO document. So keep this document handy before you begin this exercise. Maybe it would be good if you open a Word template and then start typing your experience. The first sentence should be the project objective. And the second sentence, what is the outcome against which you are? The third sentence, you begin with your role and then continue what are your responsibilities in each domain of project management. PMI divides the project management into 5 domains: initiating, planning, execution, monitoring and control, and closure. On the right side, you will see a small example which I will take it forward across all the 5 domains. The project is to implement a central PMO for your organization. Let's take it as an example. Now, the objective is to implement a central PMO. Now, the outcome is to integrate all strategic and operational initiatives, implementing global best practices in project management, and better governance. These are the expected outcomes of the project. And then third sentence, you begin with your role. For example, as the project manager, I was responsible for. Now you need to continue what you have done as part of all the 5 domains of project management. Let's continue. The first domain, initiating the project. So open the initiating domain in the ECO document, read through the tasks, and then select the tasks you personally directed or managed as part of your project. Let me take it as an example. I have done task numbers 2, 3, 4, 5, and 8 as part of PMO implementation in my project. So read these tasks carefully and rewrite them with your own project backdrop, language, and experience. Do not simply copy paste the generic descriptions PMI may reject. You can freely use your own industry acronyms and other wordings. Let me show you how I have rephrased for this domain. As the project manager, I discussed with the key stakeholders, identified key deliverables through a brainstorming session. The deliverables are a governance model, project management information system, training and support on the new system to all project team and managers. Discussed with the team about the key risks, assumptions, and constraints. Then I developed the project charter, documenting high-level scope, schedule, budget, and other key parameters, obtained management approval, and informed the key stakeholders through a formal kickoff meeting. So you see here, I have documented in three sentences on what I have done as part of initiating domain. Now this will reflect what I am supposed to do as per PMI guidelines. They reflect the tasks 2, 3, 4, 5 and 8. Let's move on to the next domain, planning. As part of the planning domain, I performed tasks 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 and 10. Now this I have paraphrased. On the left side you can read them. I formed a cross-functional core team to develop the project plan. I facilitated the team to build the work breakdown structure, schedule, resource plan, estimates of duration, cost, and to finalize the budget. We discussed the plan along with the assumptions and constraints to identify risks and developed a risk register and assumptions log. I then established quality metrics, communication, and a RASi matrix covering all functions and key stakeholders. I presented the plan to the heads of departments and the sponsor and got it approved. So this leads to about 5 sentences for the planning domain. Let's move to execution. Here, the ECO document talks about 7 tasks a PM is expected to do. I have performed tasks 1, 2, 3, 4 and 7. This is how it goes. As part of execution, all the project managers and the cross-functional team were trained in the new system and processes. I managed the team and engaged key stakeholders across the rollout of the new PMO for effective adoption. I engaged a third-party IT partner to implement the project management information system. So these are the 3 activities I managed as part of execution domain. Then move to monitoring and control. You can see the mapping to ECO tasks 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. I then translated into my own project context, and the summary goes like this. I monitored the progress on a weekly basis and discussed during the weekly review meetings. Issues were tracked using an issue log and resolved timely. I managed changes to the project systematically through a formal change request and approval process. Once the PMO systems were reviewed and accepted, I worked with a small group of PMs to move their existing projects into the new system on a pilot mode, and then it was scaled up to cover all projects and programs across the enterprise. So we got 4 sentences as part of monitoring and control domain. Finally, let's look at the closure domain. Here, I performed almost 6 out of 7 tasks, and my experience summary goes like this. Upon UAT, I accepted the new PMIS from the partner through a handover and takeover process. I identified department level coordinators to take over the operational part of PMO. The key documents and reports were archived. I organized a lessons learned workshop to discuss the whole set of lessons learned across the project that were documented time to time. I conducted an employee engagement and satisfaction survey, shared the outcome with the senior management and team. I then prepared a closure report and sent a final communication to all who participated in the project and the users of the new system. So now I have covered all the five domains. It is time to consolidate them. Summary. Assemble the summaries of individual domains into a final summary. It is always good to review your output with your colleague. If you have done multiple projects to cover the 36 months requirement, you have to repeat this for each project. Now, we at ProVentures help our workshop participants through an online template. So they normally fill it, submit it to us. We do the peer review and then give them corrections and guidelines. We give it in the form of a Word document. They can then copy the contents into the PMI online application form. If you need any further information, you can contact our training department at the following details. So when I compile five domains and the introductory part of this particular project, implementing PMO, the overall summary looks like this. When I counted it, it comes to around 400 words. Now, in order to give you a complete picture, I covered many tasks. However, depending upon the role you played in the project, you can choose the tasks accordingly and write to them. Anything more than 200 words is acceptable to PMI. Reflect honestly your experience. Do not write a theoretical essay summary. The reviewers may not like it. Finally, a little bit about us. ProVentures is one of the global REP of PMI. Over the last 14 years, we have trained more than 12,000 professionals into portfolio, program, and project management towards PMP, PGMP, and PFMP. We also train people across the world on specialty areas like scheduling, risk management, PBA, and Agile Certified Practitioner exams. We are a 360 degree PPM partner, providing consulting, implementing PMO, and we support organizations through specialty services. Thank you for watching. If you need any quote for corporate training or consulting assignments, or want to participate in our virtual or classroom trainings, feel free to contact Ratna or write to us at training@provinciousindia.com. Thank you so much for watching this video. All the best for your PMP certification journey. Bye.